Hey, it's Patti Scharf, CPA and co-founder of Catching Clouds, the leader in e-commerce accounting. Welcome back to our Saturday Slowdown, where I like to remind everybody to work on their business and not just in their business. Today, I want to kind of wrap up my discussion on women in business. This video is not really specifically women in business. It really is for everybody. So for anybody who like rolls their eyes at the women in business thing, I want you to stick around because this is really for everybody and not just women. So let's get started. So I got some great comments on my last video, the glass ceiling. I want you to go check that out if you haven't already. But there was one comment that really stuck out in particular for me, and it was, I do think some women just don't want to play the games to advance or don't want to advance. And I want to say that, okay, the fact that women don't want to advance, okay, that's just ludicrous. Everybody wants to be the best version of themselves. Otherwise, you know, the diet industry wouldn't be so healthy every January. You know, it's like everybody wants to do their best, be better, and be a better version of themselves. So I think advancement kind of goes along with that. And the idea that women don't want that is just not accurate, honestly. But the idea that women don't want to play the games to advance, that right there is hitting the nail on the head. I think that what's going on is that women see kind of what it takes to succeed in this world. And a lot of women are just like, you know what? My family is my priority. I don't want to be away from them. I don't want to, you know, have drinks at night with everybody just to kind of move up in the ranks. And the problem is that, you know, like I think back to any of you who have seen like the Mad Men series, you know, where the men, they were the ones who made the rules. They really weren't involved in child rearing or anything like that. They really defined what it took to advance at a different company. You know, they were the ones who were like, hey, if I want to succeed here, I want to put all my effort into it. And basically, they didn't have to divide their attention, right? But I don't think that's accurate anymore. I think in today's day and age, for both men and women, everybody has kind of evolved into a new sense of what they want out of life, what their priorities are. And I see this equally in men and women. Men want to be involved in raising their kids. They want to be there at the soccer games and karate and spelling bees or whatever. So I think that the rules of the game have really not changed at the same pace that I think society has changed. I think that there's something that's just out of sync right now that's going through an evolution. I will tell you that there are a crazy number of husband-wife teams who start up e-commerce businesses. I mean, the percentages on that are just kind of astronomical. It kind of blows me away. And I think it's because of this. Like, people, they start out in whatever career and they trip upon e-commerce in particular because it allows people to create kind of the life that they want. I know so many people who have like bought an RV and like started homeschooling their kids, and they just drive around the country and they work and they live and they show their kids the world. And I think it's awesome. You know, people are starting to create new worlds for themselves, design what they really want their professional life to look like. And I think all of that is possible because of the new cloud economy. You can now run your business from anywhere in the world. One of our mantras when we started our company was, we want to run our business from any beach in the world, and we want our clients to be able to do the same. And I don't think that we're unique. I think that it's running rampant through society right now. So the problem is that there are these like patriarchal views of what it really takes to succeed, what you need to do. And then there's this whole desire, and there's this new culture emerging that's kind of hopefully going to squash those said prior views. So I think because of the cloud economy, you don't have to play the game anymore. You can create your own game. Now, let me just tell you, I am a like huge rule follower. I'm an accountant. Most accountants are. They want to know what the rules are, and then they follow all those. But I think the difference with me and other people is if I don't like the rules, I just create my own set of rules, and then I follow those. It doesn't change my nature. I just think that it's important to always kind of question what you're doing. So I think this goes back to my video on self-limiting beliefs up there, where I really think the point of it is that you should be challenging your own thinking. You should be challenging the rules. You should be challenging the status quo. If something doesn't make sense, like I really want the rule to have a purpose. And I'm not going to follow a rule if it's something that doesn't align with my morals or my views or whatever. I think that it's important to create the game that you want to play. And my version of the game includes a lot more women up at the top, you know, because I mean, we're more than half of the US. So you would think that we would be able to create a world that is inclusive of all of us. You know what I mean? Let me give you one more example. When Scott and I started Catching Clouds, our intention was to design a business that we would want to work in. So we purposely made it so that everybody could work from home in their pajamas or wherever they are. You know, they could work from any beach in the world. And we purposely made it so that you don't clock in and out. It's everything is based on the results that you're bringing to the team. And we purposely made it so that everybody has unlimited vacation. And it totally works for our culture. I mean, we basically built a business, you know, what kind of culture do we want? You know, do we need to track billable hours? Well, we reject that notion. So we just don't do it, you know? And I think that, I think it's possible in this day and age. And I think that everybody should do it. So I guess in short, what I'm saying is we're really in a new era. And what we need to have happen is for women to recognize that we're in a new era, that there are so many more possibilities. And all that women have to do is recognize that there's this shift and then stand up and take action. And that's it. And I think that when there's a mental shift, then change will naturally occur. So hopefully I'm bringing some more awareness to people. Okay, and before I sign off, I want to give a shout out to my friend Amanda Aguilard, who is doing a webinar at the end of this month on CPA, CEO, Mom, a transparent talk about having it all. I am super proud of her for putting this together. I think so many women try to give you the Instagram view of what life is like, especially as an entrepreneur, and she's going to have the courage to bear it all and kind of give you the honest lowdown. So yay to her for making her dreams come true, and I hope you all check it out. I've got a coupon down below if you want to attend for $10, like what a super major bargain. So that's it. I hope you got something out of this video. If you did, please like, comment, and share. If you haven't already, please subscribe, and I'll catch you later.